My name is Seth Kluett. I'm the assistant director of the Sound Art Program at Columbia University, and I'm the curator of Sounding Circuits Audible Histories at the Vincent Astor Gallery at the New York Public Library for the Performing Arts at Lincoln Center. You know, from the earliest times that I started to get interested in electronic music, you always heard about the Columbia-Princeton Electronic Music Center and the RCA Mark II synthesizer and the work that happened here in the 70s and 80s around the development of new technologies for electronic music. And as I went through my education, it turned out I got to know more and more people associated with Columbia. Since May of 2017, I've been the artist in residence at Bell Labs, and now I'm in the position of the acting director at the Computer Music Center. And that kind of bookends the two poles of early electronic and computer music. Bell Labs was a hotbed of early research into speech synthesis and digital signal processing. And anyone who was here at Columbia or at Princeton who wanted to hear their sounds had to go to Bell Labs in the 60s in order to render them on their on the only digital to analog converter on the East Coast. People have been amazed at the hardware the most, that these devices, for one, still exist, and that they still exist here, and they're in our collections, and in some case, they're still in use in our facility, and that anyone could use it at all to make music. I'm creating a series, a suite of seven small works, 30 seconds to a minute long, that alternate with eight sort of 30 second to a minute long excerpts from classic pieces of electronic and computer music. The Sphere uses a kind of audio rendering called ambisonics, which is a 360 degree audio experience. But the goal is to help people understand how fresh these historic works sound and help give a context for some of the impact of those works on my own practice. And what I'm hoping with this exhibition to show is that these are real human beings engaging with other real human beings, trying at a time when there are no references, no precedents to come up with a new way of making sound. And I think Columbia and Bell Labs and the New York Public Library are in a very unique position to be able to show people how vibrant those interactions between people were.